So who is from IT field? Oh, and who isn't from IT? Wow, that's great. Who is a manager, kind of manager, and who is doing the real work as opposed to management? Okay. Who knows about Kanban? Who knows what it is roughly? Who is using Kanban in your life? Some of you do. Oh, great. That's good. Okay, so, yes, again, thanks Microsoft and Agile Latvia volunteers for making this happen, which is great. My name is Aleksejs. I had and have a lot of roles in IT, all of them I hope successful. Now my day job is in the bank, and my night job is related to helping people to do something they weren't able to do before. Helping people learn something, which is great. Yes, I'm exploring BDD now. Is here somebody doing BDD? Raise your hand, please. Wow, it would be nice to talk later then, because of, well, but I have some experience with it, I'll tell you about it probably. If you have a question, raise your hand immediately and ask me, so that I will answer it immediately, and you will not forget it, and we will forget to ask it afterwards.
What is BDD?
Oh, BDD. It was a test for the question part. It's a behavior-driven development, okay, which basically means you specify acceptance tests first, but it's not exactly what I said. This is what I'm exploring from. It's a huge story. Fine. So, yes, Kanban. To talk about Kanban, we have to understand that it comes from Toyota production system and what later became Lean. And again, there are better specialists on this in this sort of term than me, probably. I'll try to remind you roughly what it is about in my understanding. So it all starts with value. You have to understand first what's value in what you're doing, what's the value your customers are paying for. Then you go through your process and map the value to process steps and say, okay, this step of this process brings me that much value, this step that much value. And when you have finished doing it, everything else which doesn't produce value is a waste. You just drop it and everything is nice. Yeah, that's the general idea behind Lean, but it doesn't work this way. But anyway, Lean means you have to identify waste. And waste may be of many, many different kinds. It may be like unnecessary moving. We're moving something there, like transportation. It might be inventory. That's one of the worst things probably. Which means we're building something, we're investing our money into building something, piling it in piles, and it's sitting there waiting for something to happen, not bringing us any value because we're not selling it. We haven't finished producing it yet. Yeah? And even worse, we're paying someone for keeping it safe, which is completely insane. But still we're doing it. Yeah? It's inevitable. The question is how much inventory can you keep, how much can you reduce it? Because another major goal is to achieve smooth flow. It's like a small piece of work, like a minimum marketable feature, for example, for software, to make it move through our process smoothly, not stopping everywhere. Yeah? And again, if we try to reduce inventory, we find some problems. When we're looking into how smooth it's moving through the process, we're finding problems. It might be quality problems, like here I'm producing something and giving it to the next step, and at the next step they have to bend, mend, and squeeze it to make it usable. Yeah. So here's what, this is what we want to discover looking at our process, and this is the waste we're going to eliminate. I read two great books on this subject. There are many more, but since I read these two, I can safely recommend them to you. Read them and be happy. Nothing more about Lean from me today. So let's move to the Kanban itself. Kan means visual and ban means card. That's it. That's Kanban. Originally, it was a card with this card. One step was notifying another step that we need more work. We are ready to take in more work. Yeah? So Kanban really has two main ideas. First, we are pulling the work. We are not giving the next step some work, but we are asking the previous step, give me the next item, please. And you are not free to do it at any moment. You have a work in process, in progress limit imposed on you. So you have limited capacity. Say you cannot be doing more than two items simultaneously. If you have these two items in your hand, you cannot take the third, you don't have any more hands. Until somebody next to you have taken one from you, you cannot take a new one. That's the idea. What it means in practice, it means the following. If there is some problem down the line, if there is stuck pipeline, and you cannot proceed further, you just cannot do anything, you're staying here and trying to understand what to do. And this is your opportunity to go there and try to fix the problem. Not produce more and more and more things which cannot be processed later because of this problem, but go and fix it first. And this flow shall be visualized for you to understand how it works. I'll show you the Henrik Knieberg cartoon, which is kind of popular for such presentations. We hope to get him in Riga someday, and then it will be nice to see him in action here. Let me make it smaller, bigger, smaller. Okay, that's more or less okay. So now it will get more clear, at least for persons doing software development. What we have here? That's my red light. Oh, it works. So we have two administrators or operations people, we have four developers, and we have one product owner. Enough of that. Oh, sorry. We have board, probably a whiteboard, and these numbers are work in progress limits. So what happens here is, first the product owner pulls in two items from a backlog, deciding these are the most important things to work on. Fine. He cannot get more in because of this limit. He can get only two. What happens next? Developers are happy to take this work. They're working in pairs. So one pair is taking A, another pair is taking B, and they're working on it, which is okay. Meanwhile, product owner pulls in two more items. He can't do it now because of it was free. Yeah, now it's again two. First pair of developers have finished their work. It's done. Operations look, see something to deploy, and pull in item A. And are happily deploying it. Developers have taken another item into work. So far, so good. Here are some problems appear, but the problems are not evident yet to all the team. It's just operations people here trying to deploy this thing. It doesn't work for some reason. They're cursing developers, but not actually telling anyone. But soon it will be evident to developers as well because of Kanban nature. Why? Because of C, the second pair of developers have finished B. They want to take another one. They want to take this D. This is just naturally for developers to do. But they can't because of their limit is reached. They have two items here in development. They cannot push it out because of it's not a push system, it's a pull system. They wait for operations to pull it in. And operations don't pull because of their busy with A. They don't want one more of this nightmare on their hands. So what happens? Developers, being conscious adult people, go and look what the problem and try to help. Try to help operations. Yeah, you see, as it usually happens. Okay. Later, the pair who has produced the A originally have finished their work well. They can't pull in anything anyway because there are still two items in development. Oh, they have nothing left but go enjoy them. And finally find what the what they have produced and fix it, hopefully. So after fixing it, this will flow normally. Do you understand more or less how it works?
Yeah, no one works when there are problems.
Huh?
No one works when there are problems.
No one? That. It wasn't like no one works. The only person never working almost was the product owner, you see. He's just staying there or walking around.
As usual.
As usual. We never see them working, they're working somewhere else. Okay. So let's get back to what else I can say about it. Indeed, Kanban is kind of easy to implement, in a sense, because of it's not like implementing a Scrum in a waterfall team or whatever. It's just you put in a whiteboard on the wall, draw some lines, put some work in progress limits, and move your tasks there. Nothing more. It doesn't require you to change your process drastically. On the contrary, it makes you understand something about your process. Looking at this board daily, looking how items are moved or stuck there, you come to some conclusions, and then you came to them. Then it's much easier for you yourself to understand what change is necessary in your process. It's much better than somebody like your management or some consultants coming in and telling you how you should work with overcome your problems. This is what I like about Kanban. It can be done basically with any software development process you have. Whiteboard will not hurt anyone. It's always possible. Kanban also doesn't tell you anything about iteration length. You can release daily, weekly, whatever, monthly. It's still possible to do Kanban. Moreover, it's probably easier to do Kanban if you have daily iterations than Scrum. Your retrospective planning meeting and whatever will not fit into one day anyway. Cadence. Then the question is, what happens to cadence? Because of this Scrum or some other processes, we have cadence in form of iterations. Everybody knows we're releasing every 2 weeks. We can measure our velocities statistically somehow, like we're releasing that many story points per iteration, and we're happy with it, probably. With Kanban, it's different. With Kanban, you measure your throughput. With Kanban, you can measure how many store points you produce per week, for example. And this speed may be more or less constant if you have same team, same project, same kind of tasks. It doesn't happen. Okay, let's do it. Some teams do show you, they do the following. They put here a sign saying something like, from dear product owner, from here, once we pull your task into work, it's 2 weeks until it's live. And this is what gives business predictability. This is what they want from us, predictability. And we can measure it statistically and try to ensure this SLA with some probability. This is how it happens. Okay, as somebody said already, there are idle people. Nobody works. First, it's okay. If we consider theory of constraints, for example, it says, if I interpret it right, that the only place which is working all the time is your bottleneck. Everybody else is working faster and therefore have idle time. From other theory, if you don't have idle time, your lead time increases exponentially. So you actually do not process anything at all. You can see this effect, for example, in network routers. So it's okay to have idle time. The only thing you have to bother with is to make a wise decision of how you spend it. You can spend it on exploring something for the future. You can spend it resolving bottlenecks. You can spend it helping another Kanban item. In Kanban terms, they call it swarming. What we saw was swarming. Many people swarming on the same task because of it has to be done to release the process to allow it to go further. Again, Kanban, as I presented it, is on micro level, is on separate task level. Therefore, the problems it will identify are micro problems. Sometimes you want bigger problems to look for, and then you can do Kanban on a higher level or multiple level Kanban, like Kanban at a task level, Kanban on project level, or project portfolio level. Yeah, that's also possible. And again, what I like is Kanban protecting people from being given more work than they deserve, than they could bear. For some teams, it's actually nothing new, except names. Yeah? So some teams are doing something like this intuitively. Well, it means they just don't need any Kanban, they're perfect already, that's okay. For some teams, the advantage is already there because of their using time boxing very wisely. It's okay as well. For in some Kanban implementations, the main effect people were seeing was coming from the fact that before Kanban, they were estimating and planning every possible task they had. Implementing Kanban, they suddenly understood that, well, it's no point to invest in estimating something which isn't going into process anyway in the nearest months. Yeah? And this wasn't the main achievement, the main efficiency achievement. Some argue that Kanban is better suited for things like operations and maintenance because of it works well in unpredictable environment when your tasks are coming in some unpredictable manner. Well, it's true, but software development, even in normal projects, is kind of unpredictable sometimes. And you shall not forget, Kanban will give you complete software management lifecycle, project management, whatever. So remember about it. Speaking of my or our personal experience at Citadel, we don't call it Kanban, but we have one team doing something very similar. We just don't call it any names, we just use it. We don't have a whiteboard, we don't need it. This picture is somewhere else in other systems, but if I would like to draw it, I draw it like this, like 15 or 20 columns for people, for each person individually. Separate work in progress limits for projects and small maintenance tasks people are doing. Again, that's because of the same team is doing simultaneously project development and maintenance and support. So we are not only producing software, we are maintaining it afterwards. It makes us produce better software, but we have to maintain it afterwards. We cannot push it on someone else. Which is good. What it allows us to do is basically deliver daily. If task is ready, we can push it out. If deployment is somewhat complex, we can push it out twice a week, which is also okay mostly for business. Probably it's possible because of we have very experienced people for you and everybody, for them to work with me. It's easy to do without any formal process with people who are really responsible and reliable. And it still allows us to see our inefficiencies or possible improvements. And one of the improvements we are working on now is to prioritize backlog exactly before we are pulling something. Now there is a lag. I want to.